Welcome back. In this session, we are going to understand how to send this RFQ to the vendor. Go to this T code ME9A. See, now we are in message output. What we have to do here? Here we need to enter these details, RFQ numbers. Go here. Remove this, paste here, execute this. See, these are the RFQs. This is not an ALV report. If you need a ALV report for ME9A, what we have to do, we know how to default values from SU3 T codes. Here is the path: system, user profile, own data. Here you will find parameters. Under this parameter, we need to add one parameter for getting ALV report. See, this is the parameter here. So copy this. You need to maintain like this. Here, press enter. ALV grid control in purchasing reporting. Capital X, save this. Close this window. Now go to ME9A. Right now it is not ALV. Go back. Copy this again. Execute this. See, now we are getting ALV report. Hope you understand. If you don't get ALV report, you need to maintain this ME use grid in parameters. What we are doing here, select this, click on a display message. See, this is we are sending to the vendor. This is vendor number. See here, request for quotation. We are asking the vendor to submit a quotation against this requirement. Material number is this, quantity is this, article description is this. So like this, we are going to send this RFQ to three different vendors. Select last one, display message. See, this is vendor number. If you want to make any modification in this form, you need to take the help of Abapar to make a further enhancement in this RFQ printout. So select all. So far we didn't send. If you want to send, click on output message. See, processing status, message, output. So how to check this output? You need to go to another T code called SP01. This is a spool request. Whatever you are printing, it is going to be appear here. By default, you are getting your user ID, date, client. Just execute. See, three RFQs has been printed. How to check this one? Click on type. See, this is the first RFQ, this is second one, this is third one. Hope you understand how to send this RFQ to vendor. This is the default output device. This is defaulted at user level only. You can see this. Go to user profile, own data, here defaulted here, output device. In next step, we are going to receive the information from the vendor and we will understand how to enter those information in SAP.